Welcome back to the shop, friends. Last week, I picked up a new workbench to serve as my accessory workbench here in the wood shop. Thought you guys might like to see it. Might be a good fit for your shop. So this is the Harbor Freight hand tool workbench, and the majority of it, including the top, is built from hardwood. So I paid $149 plus tax for this workbench. Now, if you remember back several years ago when I built my Paul Sellers workbench, I spent about $150 on build materials for that workbench. That did not include the vise. So included in the $149 is the work surface, the four drawers, the shelf at the bottom, and you also get an end vise. The workbench top measures 60 inches long and it's 20 inches wide. Now, looks can be a little bit deceiving here because by looking at the side of the workbench, it looks like the top is very thick. But in fact, the wood is actually only 3/4 inch thick on the top of the workbench. I'm having a little bit of trouble identifying the type of hardwood that's used on the workbench. It's definitely hardwood though. I tried screwing through it a couple times and it's hard, hard, hard. According to the box, this workbench was built in Vietnam, so I'm not sure if this wood is indigenous to that area or if it's a hardwood that's found in the United States. I'm just not sure. If you're able to identify what type of wood it is, be sure to put that in the comments. I'd really like to know. What's interesting about this workbench is it's made from lots of short pieces of wood that have been end jointed together. They measure, I don't know, right around 10 inches long. The whole work surface is that way. Now, one nice thing about the workbench is they've already drilled the dog holes and they measure 10 inches apart lengthwise and then are 12 inches apart side to side. Additionally, here at the vise, they put three other dog holes that are closer together. And then there's two dog holes in the vise surface so you can clamp boards on your workbench. The workbench also comes with these dogs, and as you can see, they fit in the holes nicely, and then they can be used to clamp your boards down. These dogs are really nice. I don't have any major complaints about them. Now, while we're here at the vise, I'll say that the vise is pretty nice, especially being that it's included in the price of $149. It'd be pretty difficult for you to build this workbench and add a vise to it for $149. If you can do it for $149, that's pretty awesome and I'd like to hear about it. Now, one thing I'll say about the handle for the vise, it's not fit properly to the vise and it's just got these sort of plastic or rubber stoppers on there. So they can easily fall off, and you know, if you're cranking down the vise, it can certainly fall off. So you might want to turn yourself one that's fit properly here and then put some nice knobs glued on the end so it won't fall out. So the face of the vise measures about 12.5 inches, and then the throat of the vise is it's about 7 1/16. So let's go ahead and take a look at the front of the workbench. You've got a 2.5 inch board that's screwed onto your worktop all around the entire thing. Now, unfortunately, they didn't fill these screw holes, and that's something that I'll probably do in the future. I'm not sure if it's glued or not, but it'd be nice to actually take those screws off or take those screws out in case you ever need to do some planing. Now, you also have four drawers on the front, and the front of the drawer is made from hardwood. Now, the rest of the drawers are made from plywood, and they also have a felt lining on the inside that's pretty nice. Now, the drawer slides are quite cheap and they're sort of flimsy. I guess it's sort of expected on a cheap workbench like this, but you don't have the full drawer slides on these. You only have about 8 3/4 inch opening on the drawers. Now, the drawers are deeper than that. They're actually 13 inches deep. So I filled this workbench up pretty fast, unfortunately. I'm using it really for all those guitar specific tools that I've accrued for building the acoustic guitar. Now, on the bottom of the workbench, you've got a shelf, and the shelf is it's about 17 inches deep, and then the shelf goes between the legs of the workbench and it goes about 47.5 inches long. The shelf itself is made out of a piece of, I think it's 1/2 inch plywood that's got a piece of laminate on top of it. It's a little bit flimsy, and the shelf runner here is a little bit flimsy, but no big deal. I think it's rated for something like 250 pounds. So as you would expect from a store-bought piece of furniture or workbench in this case, is it came in a lot of pieces and you've got to assemble it. And most of the pieces are assembled using screws or some type of locking nut hardware that they include with it. It took my son and I probably about an hour to put it together, and it went together pretty smoothly. We didn't really run into any major issues. So one of the reasons I decided to buy this workbench is it's the exact same length as my Paul Sellers workbench. Fits really nicely up against it. It's just a little bit lower than the Paul Sellers workbench is. So let me give you a short summary of the workbench. It's pretty nice. It's $149 plus tax. Be very difficult to build one for that price, especially with a vise and especially out of hardwood. It's a little bit top heavy. It doesn't have quite enough weight on the bottom of it. So if you're planing on it, it seems to wobble a little bit. I think that could be remedied by adding maybe a new foot to each one of the legs, or I think you could add some type of storage to the bottom of the workbench and that would add a lot of weight to the bottom of it. So I'm planning to completely soup up this workbench and make it awesome. But I need you guys to hit that thumbs up, and I need 1,000 likes on this video and I'll show it here on the channel. So I don't think this is a workbench your great grandkids are really gonna want. However, I think this is a really good starter workbench that you could use to create those things that you want to hand down to your grandkids. I suspect that I'm going to get a lot of use out of it. I have already been using it for the past week or so, and I really like it. If you already have this workbench and are using it in your shop, I'd love to hear about it. I'd love to hear your thoughts about it. So this is not the first Harbor Freight tool that I reviewed. Earlier this year, I did a 5-year review on their cheapest drill press. You might want to check that out now.